Welcome, I'm Dr. Janine Bowring, naturopathic doctor, and today I'm talking about the science of turmeric and the benefits of turmeric. So we know that in the scientific literature, there are thousands and thousands of studies that look at the medicinal components of that active ingredient, curcumin, and the turmeric, and this is really important for, again, doing things naturally. So let's take a look at some of that science of turmeric now, some of the best benefits that are proven in the literature. So number one is the anti-inflammatory effect. So studies have shown that what turmeric does is it helps to decrease something called CRP, which is the C-reactive protein, specifically in rheumatoid arthritis patients. So for anybody suffering with chronic inflammatory conditions like rheumatoid arthritis, then this may be something that you definitely want to consider in terms of adding into your daily routine. So we know that a little bit of acute inflammation is actually good for us and serves a purpose. It helps with our immunity, helps with actually mounting a little bit of an anti-inflammatory response, which is good. But over time, chronic low-grade inflammation is linked to the aging process. And this is not something necessarily that we want. So the great thing about turmeric is that it has that anti-inflammatory effect. It's known as having a COX-2 inhibitor effect and a 5-LOX inhibitor effect, which is very comparable to a lot of the COX-2 inhibitor drugs, but studied up against, you know, some of these conventional ways of treating pain and inflammation, turmeric and actually the curcumin, the active component, has actually done much better. Now, it also has a pain-killing effect, so an analgesic effect. In this study, it was shown that at the dosage of 200 to 400 milligrams of the turmeric, it was very comparable to the non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs for treating pain and that inflammation. And here we can see that, you know, improvement in the DAS and the ACR scores, and this was significantly better in the patients than and compared to those taking even a conventional drug for rheumatoid arthritis. So that's a pretty big statement, as well as having analgesic effects post-operative, as well as for arthritic pain and for chronic, you know, long-standing pain. So that is fantastic. What I love about turmeric is that it doesn't have those negative side effects in terms of compromising digestion and causing, you know, some of the other side effects that often go hand in hand with the conventional drugs for treating pain and inflammation. Also, we know that turmeric is a powerful antioxidant, so that has both beauty benefits, but also in terms of preventing disease and looking at the anti-carcinogenic effect of turmeric, especially the curcumin. In this study, we can see that, you know, the researchers were looking for the polyphenol compound, especially with and tying that into being an effective drug, and they use the word drug for cancer therapy, and that means that, you know, out of all of those over 12,000 papers on curcumin, over 4,000, we're looking at the link between curcumin and cancer, and meaning that 30% of those published papers on curcumin were looking at the medicinal aspects and how it could have a positive impact on cancer. So that is a huge statement, and I'm sure that studies will continue in this department in terms of being able to use turmeric, especially that concentrated curcumin, as a cancer therapy. Also, we know that turmeric helps to balance blood glucose levels. So this is really important for anybody with metabolic syndrome, as well as insulin sensitivity. Also, that ties into hormonal weight loss. So studies have shown that what turmeric does is it helps to decrease leptin levels. And also in this study, the combination for, you know, weight loss of the turmeric plus the black seed oil helped with metabolic syndrome. And this is a double-blind randomized controlled trial. So, you know, great, great results in terms of being able to, again, now maximize the absorption of the turmeric with taking it with something fatty, the black seed oil being a healthy fat, and has its own medicinal benefits on its own, which I get a lot of questions about. about. So that combination may be something that you want to try as well. Also the beauty benefits. So we can't do an episode without talking about the beauty benefits, of course, and the antioxidant status, you know, that the curcumin has helps to induce a little bit of stress in the skin. And this is where I talked about a little bit of inflammation, a little bit of stress, all often helps our redox signaling and the anti-aging, you know, benefits due to that antioxidant response, because now the body's going to have to respond to that. And this can maximize, you know, the look and the feel of your skin. Also, it can be used as an acne spot treatment. So this is something that I shared in another video. I have it here. This is something that this recipe I share in that video. So this is great for pigmentation. It's great for acne scars, and you use that right on the skin wherever it's needed. So you can definitely check out that recipe on my YouTube channel here. It's natural acne spot treatment, and you can learn how to do this. It has beeswax in it, shea butter, as well as of course the concentrated curcumin, which is awesome. And we also know that, you know, to slow down that aging process, because the curcumin has that natural anti-inflammatory effect, is very beneficial as well. So using it both topically, but also ingesting it, of course, for that antioxidant status. Also for digestive health, we know that curcumin and turmeric help with gas and bloating. It's also been found that they help with the gut microbiome. So again, having that healthy gut flora and the good diversity of the gut bugs is really important for, you know, overall digestive health, but for immune function as well. Also for liver and gallbladder health. So for fatty liver, this has been studied, and in this study in the literature, it shows that the treatment of non-alcoholic fatty liver disease with curcumin, again, a randomized placebo-controlled trial, so, you know, a great way to evaluate. And there was a 78.9% improvement in the curcumin group versus the placebo group in terms of, you know, reducing body mass index, serum levels of total cholesterol, the LDL cholesterol, triglycerides, some of the liver enzymes, the glucose, and the glycated hemoglobin compared to the placebo group. So again, a great study. Definitely check that out. We will share all of the links to the studies down in the description below. So make sure you check those out. Also helping with gallbladder health and gallbladder inflammation. So we know that curcumin is definitely helpful in this regard as well. So for people who have gallstones, or I even, you know, usually educate people about, even if you've had your gallbladder removed, then it is so important for your overall, you know, liver health to make sure that you're incorporating the turmeric, you know, in, and especially with that standardized extract of the 95th percentile of the curcuminoids. That's really important when you're looking in terms of a concentrated, you know, source or a supplement for this. So we'll be sure to share those links below where you can get your hands on that as well. And also for kidney health. So we know that the curcumin helps to protect the kidneys from the damage, and they've studied certain drugs and damage to the kidneys, and the curcumin was very helpful in this regard, and also helps our mitochondrial function and the redox potential in our mitochondria, which is really important for our overall energy production in our body. Also, we know that turmeric and the science behind turmeric actually helps with brain function, so helping to increase something called BDNF, which I've talked about in other videos, and those feel-good hormones. So it has been proven, again, that the turmeric helps with serotonin levels and dopamine levels, so can be potentially used as a natural antidepressant. As well as, this is interesting for all of the vegetarians and vegans out there, that often there you could be compromised in your DHA levels. And in this study, it showed that curcumin actually boosts the DHA levels in the brain. So that's important for, you know, anxiety disorders, as we can see here, but also for brain function, also for circadian rhythms, also for making sure that your leptin signaling is happening appropriately. So make sure you check out my other videos on leptin resistance if you miss those, and why that's so important to get that under control and healthy again, so that you have good overall health. So I hope that you learned something new in this video. I would love to hear from you in the comments below. If you've got a question as well, please do put it in that section below. Also, be sure to share this video I truly appreciate a big thumbs up and a like on this video and my others as well. And if you're new to my channel, welcome in. I hope that you'll subscribe. Also, click that bell to turn on the notifications so you'll always get my newest and latest uploads. And remember to always take good care of your health and do it naturally. Thanks for watching today.